Here we go again with the Trademo Show with Matthias and Sebastian.
Hello again.
How are you today, Matthias?
I'm fine. So the weather is very, very sunny, and yeah, I feel great. So it's like summer.
I think your image is frozen, though.
Really? Okay. Yeah. But you can imagine my happy face.
Yeah. It just looks sad on the screen. But okay, it's like this permanently frozen, stern face there. Okay.
Is it still frozen? No.
Yeah, it's frozen, but it's also beautiful in a way, Matthias.
Okay, but I restarted the camera twice, so it should work now.
And yet it is not helping. Okay, doesn't matter. Let's go on and just watch you in your beautiful, sinister face. Okay, no, now it's working. I fixed it.
Okay, cool.
Okay, good. Here we go. And this is live, so if you want to ask us any questions, go ahead. We are... Yeah, let me go back to show you the topic here once more. Trade management wisdom, Bitcoin, and the trade desk. Yeah, so why am I bringing this topic here? We increased our position in the trade desk on Friday or... Yeah, was it? No, on Thursday. No, on... Yeah, Friday.
I think it was Friday, yeah, because Friday. I wasn't there.
Yeah, Friday we increased the position in the trade desk. First position was at 55. Next position here after the almost... After it broke out above the 64... We entered at 66, and now we are in this situation here and see trade desk go down 5% yesterday. And that's of course very painful when you have just increased your position. So I wanted to ask one of the people that I know can handle this the best, both psychologically from the position size and by just not giving much of a in this situation. Basically, yes. Matthias is stone cold and still has a lot of heart. So, share your wisdom.
That's a nice explanation. I would say the first position you entered at 55 is far away in the green zone, I would say, or not?
Yeah, it is.
Yeah, and just the second one is in the red now.
So but let's also imagine we... Let's imagine it was on our first position at 66, because it's not unreasonable to buy the trade desk there. I mean, that's why we did it.
Yeah, so I would say it's important to calculate if you want to hold this position for maybe 1, 2, 3 years. So it's a kind of investment, or it's just a trade for a few weeks, days, maybe hours. Then you have to calculate the risk completely differently. So what was your expectation about the position?
This is a longer term position, but of course I would have been happier to see it continue upwards immediately.
Of course. Nobody wants to see it go, the money go away.
In principle, it's not a stock that I intend on selling actually any time during the next 3 years.
This horizon, I would say the stop loss isn't the thing you have to consider. So I think 10, 15, even 20% of decrease is okay. So because you want to hold the position for a longer time and you want to earn your dividend maybe. And this is part
dividend,
of the game.
But I expect the stock to go up 100% during those 3 years.
The only thing I would consider is regarding the trading account. So the total loss of this single position shouldn't be larger than 10%.
Yeah,
but well, I think this is the case here.
Paid attention and only put a it's not small. The total position is now I think 9% of our account, but we would have to lose all of it for it to affect our account in a dramatic way.
Yeah. Okay, so this doesn't matter in my in my opinion.
So now let's take the other scenario. Let's imagine this was a, a momentum trade, and we want to keep it. Yeah, basically we want to ride this trend. So in this situation, my inclination would be to keep it until it goes below 60, because 60 was the base of the last breakout. And I would wait for a close below 60 as part of my momentum trading strategy.
Yeah, this could be one approach, but I think another one can be to say I earned for first position, which started at 55, and you can take this as a kind of subvention for the
subsidy.
Second position.
Subsidy is the English word.
Yeah. For the second position, and overall the risk is maybe zero, or you're making a little win out of it when the second position is stopping out.
Yeah.
And in this case, I would take more risk. Because the first one is a gift for me.
Okay, I see. So you would even accept a drop below 60?
Yes. If the total risk is then not below zero, then I would take more risk.
It would probably be below zero if it drops below 60.
Yeah, in this case, I would be more carefully and take a stop loss. And I have no clue. I didn't calculate it, but maybe 61, 62, something like that.
Okay, understood. Okay, good. Yeah, I think this is an interesting exercise for everyone who is trading actively and wants to manage the positions, and also for those who have a longer-term position and just need to deal with the emotion of a loss on a single day. But let's take a look now at Bitcoin.
Last Friday,
new highs. We entered a short here at 5,800 because we expected some kind of pullback first, and that is working so far. Now what's going on in the Bitcoin markets? I mean, we basically have this expectation of another of forks in the altcoins, and also Segwit 2 coming up in, I think there's no date for Segwit 2, but there's a date on the, I think the 25th is a date to keep in mind when you're in the crypto world. Let me just check what it was. Bitcoin Gold is launching on the 25th of October, I believe. And that could, it's basically yet another competitor for Bitcoin that could influence things. Yeah. But
When I have a look at the Bitcoin chart, then the only thing what makes me a little bit concerned is that we go sideways since 4 days. And usually this is not a scenario where the price goes down. Usually sideway markets is just taking breath, and then the next step will follow. So in my opinion, we should close a position or part of the position in our short position Bitcoin.
Okay, yeah, I understand. Let's do this then after the show.
It's an
interesting. Yeah, it didn't even break below the 5,400. So basically points towards a continued upward trend. Yeah, I agree. But at the same time, with these fundamentals there, it depends on many factors. Also the Chinese elections. So it's not really elections, but the Chinese party shuffles. If the more conservative parties win here, then they could also reduce the openness towards cryptocurrencies, which can then be a big change in the price.
The chart looks nice. Impressive.
And last but not least, Netflix has released its earnings, it's seeing a little bit of a sell-off today, even though we had an all-time high yesterday. Some funds are probably taking their profits, and also some traders who speculated, and also some people who just want to go short the day after the earnings when people are taking profits is, of course, a good day for that usually. So if you don't see a trend continuation, then there's only one way, it will go on that
Do you
day.
know where the, do you know where the earnings look like? Was it good news or was
Yeah,
it
it
not
was
so good?
great news, I think.
It was selling good news this
Yeah.
time again.
Yeah. No, but maybe we can invite somebody who's really been following Netflix for the past years and trading every quarterly earnings. Then that would be a great interview to have. So if you have know anybody, show them the link to the show and let them come on stage here. But that's it
Yes.
from us for today.
Okay.
So otherwise, indices are still at record highs. So Nasdaq here just taking a tiny dip. The Russell, okay, the Russell is rather going down, but generally here
Yeah.
S&P near all-time high, and the DAX at above 13,000. Impressive, impressive, impressive.
Absolutely.
So let's see how the markets are tomorrow, and all the best to all of you in the meantime. Check out our new landing page at Trademo. When you go to www.trademo.com, we'd love to hear your opinion. You have to switch to the English language if you aren't automatically brought there to see it. Okay, have a good one.
Okay. Have a
Bye.
nice day. Bye, guys.